Buffalo Bills. And here we go. They say they hadn't been this excited about opening day in a long time. Why? Lawyer Malloy introduced last with the defense.
At safety from Washington, number 36, Lawyer Malloy.
He's one of them now, as Bill Belichick knows what kind of player he is, but maybe he didn't anticipate it would be this bad this soon. Larry Centers, the former Bill, Takeo Spikes, one of the new defenders brought in by the Buffalo Bills, blows up the play. Then, Buffalo scoring an 80-yard drive early, Bledsoe to Dave Moore, 90-yard drive. Touchdown, threw 17 of 28, 14-0 Bills against Belichick in the pass. Then, Tom Brady, Troy Brown, nailed by Spikes. Patriots forced to punt, crowd in a frenzy. Still 14-0. Another new addition, the kid, Sam Adams, rumbling, bumbling, stumbling. Touchdown! Sam Adams goes well with wings. It's a touchdown, Bills.
Yeah, great job of swarming defense by the Bills. And look at Sam Adams. Got a
he
little
moves.
Flavor. It moves well for a big man.
He moves. He's his second touchdown. He's had many a return, a fumble scoop up, an intercepted return. This is second TD. Then, guess who's back? Lawyer Malloy, doink, out of his hands and helmet into the hands of Nate Clements. You couldn't script it better if you were Lawyer Malloy. And then, Tommy, Malloy.
Yeah, working here against tight end Christian Fourier. Great job giving him the hands, getting inside of him. And boy, did he get on top of the quarterback quick.
I'll take another look. Here he comes. Look, ba-boom. And he's maybe as good a friend as he has on the team is Tom Brady.
Yeah.
But maybe not today during these 3 hours. Brady, under pressure this time, it's Spikes. Oof. Oh, look at that. The ball just floated into Spikes' hand. And now with a 28-0 score, Brady. Not his day. Four times his worst in the interception department ever. It Spikes again. Crowd in a frenzy. Spikes, Malloy, Bledsoe. And the Patriots had beaten the Bills five straight times, but not today. It was dice, slice, and otherwise nice if you're a Buffalo fan. 31-0. As the Bills get Malloy with an interception, a sack, five tackles, two picks for Spikes. I think you get the rep the Tebow again. Buffalo Bills, boy, it was hot on the field. Over 100 degrees in Jacksonville. On the field it was. Now, Drew Bledsoe was just as hot. Look at Mark Campbell. Take that licking and keep on ticking. Rasheen Mathis on the hit, Tom. Yikes, he was
yeah,
okay.
That's a great one-hand grab. Great job holding on to the football. But, boy, can Drew put it where he wants if you give him time to throw the football.
And with 7-0 Bills the first quarter, Bledsoe to Josh Reed, 24 yards. On the same drive of the Jags, 42, Bledsoe, look at him drop it in there to Eric Moultrie. He can still throw it hard. He can drop it in, and then they get close to the goal line. It's Travis Henry, who had three touchdowns on the day. Didn't have a big rushing day because it was Bledsoe's day. 14-0 Bills. And they play defense, too, to the chagrin of Jack Del Rio.
Yeah, Jack Del Rio trying to free up Fred Taylor. You just watch his star right there. He's in the backfield in the deep set. We're used to seeing him there. Great job defensively by the Bills. Much improved defense stopping the run. Here, Fred Taylor back outside. Slot double wing open is what we call this. Ball designed to go to him. Great job of tackling. That's Antoine Winfield. Right there, making a nice, nice hit, Boom.
All right, under 2 minutes to go in the half, Tom. 14-7 Bills. Bledsoe to Bobby Shaw. The Bobby Shaw redemption. 54 yards, 21-7 Buffalo.
And we talk about a pocket. Just watch here, the beautiful pocket. No pressure on Drew. He's able to step up, step into his throw, and put it, again, exactly where he wants.
Look at that throw. To Eric Moulds, 36 yards. The Bills go on to slice and dice the Jaguars. They have that emotional win at home. Then they go on the road to a, you know, a non-division foe. You figure, 38-17, Bledsoe, 19 of 25 for 314, 7 of them to Eric
Moulds. Yeah, an outstanding job by that offensive line, because you see Travis Henry's numbers, 21 carries for 26 yards. Yes, the 21 carries we like, the 26 yards were...
Bills going for their first 3-0 start since 91. Miami hasn't lost twice at home in September since 89. And Drew Bledsoe and the Bills have been dominant in their two wins so far this season. First quarter, Bledsoe's back to pass. As you can see, Bledsoe pretty blatant as to exactly where he's going. And Sammy Knight able to pick up on the Drew Bledsoe stare. And on Bledsoe's pass to Eric Moultz, Knight is there for the pick. Still scoreless in the second quarter. A little Bills trickery. Hand off to Travis Henry. Throws it towards the end zone. Underthrew it. Picked off by Patrick Surtain. Second interception of the game. Later in the second, Bills driving again. Bledsoe going for Moles in the end zone. That is picked off by Brock Marion. Take another look. Drew staring the whole way. Even I know there's no check off there. Fourth quarter, it's 10-0. The theme continues. Jay Fiedler underthrows Nate Clements. Intercepts it, takes it 54 yards, and the Bills are on the board. His second pick of the game. Ricky Williams had himself a ball game. That's good for 21 yards. Williams had 42 carries, a franchise high, fourth most in NFL history. It's ruled a touchdown there. Dolphins win.
Bluebirds out in Philly, 0-2 start by the Eagles, then a bye. This is Sam Dana, the 100 is yes. He's the oldest living player that stayed in the NFL. He played for the 1928 New York Yankees. That's Donovan McNabb, who feels like the oldest living player, the way they've been booing him in Philly lately. But did they come out well against the Buffalo Bills, and he came out a new man.
Todd Pinkston against cover two. You see him get the one-on-one coverage at the line of scrimmage. Great job and great touch by Donovan McNabb.
On the same drive, well, this, you know what he can do. And he's having fun doing it, Tom. Mm-hmm. There's so many times the West Coast, not the West Nile offense, like you said this morning, when they script the first 15, 20 plays, they look the best. Correll General Bachhunter into the end zone. Kink. You're an idiot. Eagles lead the Bills 7-0.
And again, Donovan McNabb going to see the same coverage. Corner up. This is cover two. Safety going to be coming over again. Great touch. Sneaks it in just before the safety can get over there. Receiver James Thrash. Nice outside relief. Good play. Good toss and catch. Quarterback wide receiver.
13-0 Eagles at the half. Now 16-0 fourth quarter. Drew Bledsoe, because of Henry's out of Morris, he said, I got no running game. So the dump to Joe Burns. Really is the running back, at least at this moment, gets a first down. Fourth and goal from the three. Here comes Buffalo. Bledsoe. Look at Bledsoe on the move to Bobby Shaw. They go for two. Don't make it. It's 16-6. Bills ball again. So now all of a sudden, after being dormant for essentially two straight games on offense, Moles 23 yards. And fourth and goal from the one. Bledsoe, touchdown. Extra point good. 16-13. Third and seven. 2.5 to go. McNabb, not a big pocket, but he stayed in there to thrash.
Great job of hanging in the pocket, not having the nervous feet, and making the kind of play he need to make.
And then here it is, trying to run out the clock. They do better than back. Brian Westbrook from Villanova could go all the way. Touchdown. His 62-yard jaunt salts it away, and the Eagles win a game they had to. Buffalo, after that great start, is now back to earth at 2-2. Philadelphia wins it by the count of 23-13. And look, Bengals. Marvin Lewis got his first win last week. Buffalo Bills looking for their first win in a couple of weeks. Dakiel Spikes playing against his old team for the first time. First quarter, here's Spikes bringing down Brandon Bennett. Corey Dillon didn't make the trip. 6-yard loss. Spikes fired up. Trying for the punting team later. Scary moment in the third quarter. Former Buffalo Bill Jeff Burris injured after hitting Sam Gash. He was down on the field, attended to for a long time, but x-rays negative on his neck injury. He's okay, and that's very, very, very good news. Drew Bledsoe, screen in a 6-6 game to Travis Henry, who was determined an hour before the game would play, and he played well. 13-6 Buffalo. Rudy Johnson, yeah, into the end zone, 16 yards, and we're tied at 13. Letting it all go tonight, Tom, why not? With the score 16-13 in the fourth quarter, 4th-and-3 Bills. Eric Moles makes the first down and then some. 19 yards, Tom, and despite the good coverage.
Well, Torrey James going to be in coverage. He's up in coverage, but he doesn't do anything. Right there, tries to get a little hand on him. Moles, a great job of coming back to the football. Big receiver. And then blows by Torrey James. Boy, James looked a little slow right there.
Well, Moles one of the best in the game. Ryan Lindell with 31 seconds to go. Good. 29 to field goal. Good. We go to overtime. Bengals win the toss. 3 and out. Now it's Buffalo. Remember the overtime mastery of Bledsoe and the Bills last year? Bledsoe, Moles, 28 yards. And now Buffalo in business. And instead of kicking at this point on second and goal, Henry into the end zone. And Buffalo, it wasn't pretty. They were sluggish at times. As Bledsoe barely got over 200 yards. And the coaches shaking hands afterwards. It was Moles who hurt his groin at the end of the game. And Bills win it by the count of 22-16 with most of their games in the next month on the road. A pivotal win for Buffalo, getting back on the winning track. And Cincy, when they lose, they're close.
Well, and certainly they miss Corey Dillon. This is a team playing better football, but they miss Corey Dillon. He may be their best player.
And didn't it look like late December up there?
Absolutely. I know
it
was gray, like gray, dark,
hooded coats. And just, uh-oh, it's coming. Now, back to the action we go. Late games. Bills at Jets. Bills look good first two games of the year. The Jets haven't looked good at all, but they come off a bye. Vinny Testaverde and the Jets figuring, look, we've been down before. Let's see if we can get coming back. Testaverde, Anthony Beck, two-yard score. And Vinny Testaverde has passed Joe Montana, not Joe Montana, Joe Montana, for seventh in all-time passing yard. For Drew Bledsoe, what's going on with this offense, Tom? They're absent.
Well, you look there. There's a snap over Drew Bledsoe's head. That ball going to be recovered by the Jets. Dwayne Robertson going to be up the middle. There's another sack on a four-man rush, and then Sam Cowart finally. Again, you get the picture here, Boom. A long, long day for Drew Bledsoe.
I know Mold's not playing, and Henry back there. They haven't run the ball. Santana Moss. Well, remember they lost Morton, but Santana Moss is the guy they feel they can give him that spark. Part of the reason they let him go, and he does get the spark. Moss is going to return this 47 yards all the way to the Buffalo 18. Do I have to say it, Tom? Bills special teams. Next play for the Jets, Testaverde. To Becht, that's a pretty combo, and the J-E-T-S Jets, first couple of minutes of the third quarter, lead 20-3. More Vinny, and this is Moss, the little pitch out. Vinny and the Jets shake, rattle, and roll. The shock Buffalo Bills, Herm Edwards' team winning for the first time this year, and the Bills have fallen to 3-3. That opening day win seems like a long time ago, doesn't it, Tom?
And give the New York Jets a lot of credit for showing some resiliency. Boy, you know, you're 0-4, things are going bad. To come out and play with this kind of enthusiasm, I think a tribute to Herm Edwards and his ability to motivate.
Seven sacks.
That's right.
That'll help
us
when you get the lead.
And did it without Abraham in the lineup.
Experience for Bruce Smith, 196 and a half sacks. And back in Buffalo, he played for the Bills for 15 years. Family there. Fans there. He never got to say goodbye, and he was really looking forward to this. Jim Kelly, so many of his teammates on hand because Coach Levy, Scotty Burchtold there, they're honoring Daryl Talley on the Ring of Fame at halftime. Oh, by the way, the game. Bruce Smith was around Drew Bledsoe, who he sacked more than anyone else except Ken O'Brien in his career.
Did a great job of pressing the football, just couldn't get the sacks that he wanted today.
Bledsoe to Josh Reed, 12 yards, and with that, Jim was on hand to watch Drew Bledsoe pass him, and the 12th for the all-time career passing list. And here's Bruce.
And this was going to be a sack right here. You see Bruce jump inside. Just good movement by Drew Bledsoe to leap outside of that sack and deliver the football downfield.
Great sportsmanship and respect between the two. And here's more Bruce, Tom.
Yeah, Bruce Smith again with his patented move where he gets the arm through. Drew Bledsoe again, great job of stepping up. And here's the holding call. He goes by.
Well, that was before,
yeah. It was by that, but there's the family again. They're celebrating. He almost got the sack, and Bruce right there understands that he's got a holding call.
And there's Daryl Talley, whose name goes up in the great Bills teams, four straight Super Bowls, so they're all on hand as Talley is honored. Meanwhile, the game. Bills lead 10-0 in the third quarter. Patrick Ramsey to Rod Gardner, 25 yards, and it's a 10-7 game. Now the third. Travis Henry cuts it back. Look at Bledsoe with a block. Woo! Right there. Big game for Henry. The Bills had looked sluggish, to say the least, lately. The running game had gone south, but Henry with 21 yards. Then play action from Bledsoe, and then Josh Reed wide open. And it's fitting when Bruce Smith, Jim Kelly, and Daryl Talley are there that a guy named Reed catches the touchdown pass for Buffalo, Tom. And here's Henry. Six-yard run for Travis Henry. And then the Bills feel the running game here.
This is actually what's been missing from this offense, their ability to run, because that helps to protect Drew Bledsoe. You can see when Travis Henry gets going, he can rip off those 7, 8, 9-yard runs at one time. Here he, great patience around the corner, bursts through, and gets himself into the end zone, Boom.
167 yards rushing for Henry. The Bills, Tommy, ran for 196 yards as a team. Meanwhile, Ramsey is drilled, he's hurt. He would leave the game, and ex-Buffalo Bill Rob Johnson checks in. Guess what's going to happen? Boom! A sack. Aaron Schobel does the job. So Bruce Smith, back in Buffalo, for his team, not what he had hoped. For his old team, exactly what they hoped. The Bills back over the 500 mark, the Skins back under it, as Buffalo wins 24-7. 25-8 in first downs. The Bills had over 400 yards in offense. This looked like the team that they began the season as, with two big wins. For Washington, you got to think about protecting the quarterback here and there, Tom.
Well, I think you have to protect the quarterback by running the ball more, but that's just my little secret from the old ball coach.
Who put?
Chiefs trying to remain the NFL's only undefeated, hosting Buffalo. Yo, the pain will be there. Just how? How will Dante Hall hurt the Bills? Punt return, kickoff return, receiving or rushing? Shorty can do it all. First quarter, Trent Green, have some to Dante. 67 yards to the house. 11th career touchdown for Dante. He averages 79.8 yards per score, the highest ever in the NFL for anyone with 10 or more touchdowns. All right, Dante's nice. How about Priest?
There is a God.
I don't know what y'all came to do, but I came to praise his name.
To the Priest, 3 rushing touchdowns for Priest Holmes. And watch this. Watch Trent Green, the quarterback, puts a man-sized LaBust in your chops block. Holmes had 3 touchdowns. Chiefs win.
Buffalo at Dallas. Man, is this a payback? Although hardly anyone's there that remembers. And Drew Bledsoe certainly remembers his first NFL coach with the Patriots. That would be Bill Parcells. Bledsoe 2-3 against Parcells, but we've seen this before. Bledsoe hit, fumbles. Leroy Glover falls on it, and Dallas has him guessing already.
Yeah, and you watch the backs. They go out of the backfield, so it's minimal protection for Drew Bledsoe. Pocket collapses on him. He gets hit. He's trying to fight it. Ball out.
Then Quincy Carter, Dan Campbell. 7-0 Cowboys right before the end of the first quarter. The score is 7-3 in the second. Cowboys blitz. Al Singleton. Bledsoe never had a chance. Later in the drive, you know they're going to be coming again. You know that. And here they come. Bledsoe just gets rid of it. Well, no mystery what they're doing, Tom.
Yeah, you know, people are going to come after him, and you can see they get in a position to blitz. This is Dat Nguyen and Singleton. They're going to be coming off the edge, and Drew just doesn't have a chance to spot anybody and get rid of the football. And here they come again. You just look at the numbers. They're bringing more people than you can block, forcing you to get rid of the football, and you have no idea where. He's talking to Kevin Gilbride, the offensive coordinator, right there.
10-6 late in the third quarter. His step up, his blitz up, and it's a fumble. Parcells says it's ours. It is. I didn't realize he was an official, too. It is. Fourth quarter, 2:13 to go. 3rd and 2 for Dallas. They fake the trickery. Adrian Morrell just brought back a couple weeks ago, first down. Then Morrell, 5 yards up the middle. 3rd and 8. Morrell, look at the hole off left tackle. 17 yards. They run the clock down. Morrell at 76 yards. And, boy, the Buffalo Bills offense on the road. I know they were at Kansas City last time when they got 5. They're at Dallas. They had, 6. They're at the Jets. They had, 3. Cowboys are 7-2 as they beat the Bills 10-6. Next stop, Sunday Night Football, ESPN, Bill at Bill. First place Dallas, at first place New England. That might be good. And Buffalo, 11 years ago, it was Frank Reich leading Buffalo back against the Houston Oilers in the playoffs. They could have used Frank today, although early on, Jeff Posey, and the Bills falling the ball to touchdown, said it's only a safety. Jeff Posey drills David Carr. Carr would leave the game with a bruised right shoulder. Tony Banks in. Down 5-0. Banks to Andre Johnson, the third pick of the draft. Bills circle. No wagons on that play, Tom. It's a touchdown. 6-5 Texans. Dom Capers went for 2. They didn't make it. Jamie Sharper drills Bledsoe. Hits a fumble. Shante Orr picks it up. Play was reviewed, upheld, and the Texans beat the suddenly slumbering, and I mean deep sleep, offensive Buffalo Bills 12-10. 4 of those points coming on safeties, and Houston with 4 wins has as many wins as they won all last year under Dom Capers, who continues to impress.
And that's what we looked at, the fact that this team is improving on a week-to-week basis. Dom Capers, the perfect coach for this young football team.
And for the Buffalo Bills, a question of what happened after a very impressive 2-0 start. Offense.
At Orchard Park, New York, it's always cold at this time of the year.
However, 70 degrees. Come to Buffalo for the winter. It's great. And the Colts at the Bills. All Bills special teams. No, Bills special teams. Brian Moorman fumbles it, runs 30. 37 yards. There's the play that we're looking for.
Well planned.
Yep. And this team has not scored a touchdown in 3 weeks, but they had three safeties. There it is! A touchdown! Drew Bledsoe! Greg Williams psyched! The owner, Ralph Wilson, psyched! And the Bills have scored for the first time in a touchdown in a month! And they lead it. Now they lead 14-3 in the fourth. Edgerrin James. Whoop! 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 What a run by Edgerrin James. It's 14-9. Colts gamble. Don't get the two, so it stays a five-point Bills lead. Now, 7 minutes to go. Peyton Manning in Buffalo. Naturally, the Bills fans have to watch another team run the no-huddle, Tom. That's Dallas Clark, a great football name, for 13 yards. Aaron Moorhead, 18 yards. Then, 3rd and 6, Manning. Marvin Harrison playing gimpy, but a first down. Here we go. James, Colts, hoping. They're from the 3. 2.5 minutes to go. James to the... Whoa! He's just tackled at the 1. James, can the Bills mount a goal line stand? Yes, they do. He stopped. 3rd and goal. James. No, he's down. Tom, where is he? He's on the 1. Fly.
That's it.
Tony Dungy says, we just have a few to go. And Dermot Thomas, they honored him today. He's in the stands. Come on, defense. And Deirdre, oh, it's a touchdown. And Dermot's gone. The wagon's not circled. James, Manning, they struggle. But Tony Dungy's Colts are now 9-2 as they beat the Buffalo Bills by the count of 17-14. And last week the Colts were in a 38-31 game, Tom, but they've won them both different ways.
Yeah, Peyton Manning pretty outstanding. Good to see Edgerrin James get back on the right track. And look at those numbers. Again, Drew Bledsoe, 15-28, 35 and an INT. Hard to figure.
They got Bills, Giants. Bills have lost 4 in a row. The Giants have lost 3 in a row. Both coaches on the hot seat. Drew Bledsoe, headaches, little flu, little concussion problems. He says, hey, I'm going to play. And he connects with the tight end, Dave Moore. And you can set your watch to it. Once every 11 weeks, the Bills score an offensive touchdown on the road. 7-0 Buffalo. Kerry Collins just stumbles. Dumb and dumber. The fans kind of sum it up. Boy, turnover city. And then Bledsoe gets hit helmet by Keith Hamilton. Personal foul, Hamilton. Bledsoe stays in the game. And since you're going to score a road touchdown, why don't you go for some more? No one circles the touchdowns on the road every 11 weeks like the Buffalo Bills. Bledsoe to Eric Moulds, 21 yards. Then the Shankshaw redemption. Bobby Shaw for 18 yards. And then Travis Henry, boy, he runs hard. 13-yard touchdown. Bledsoe leaves in favor of Van Pelt after that drive. But the Buffalo Bills, the team with the chin less down, really, of these two, Tom, and they beat the Giants by the count of 24-7. In disappointing seasons for both.
Yeah, disappointing for both. But, you know, again, they're talking a lot about the quarterbacks, but Drew Bledsoe gets the concussion. You can tell he had it. He's so tough. I think we tend to forget 19-29, and this is what the Bills are looking for offensively, that combined with Travis Henry.
They had 400 yards, and the Giants had 222. They now have dropped. Gets at the Bills. Both teams won at the Meadowlands last week. Boy, the Jets looked different with Chad Pennington, but the Bills look different. This was their plan all year, Tom. Mm-hmm. Travis Henry to run the ball. Mm-hmm. And Buffalo leading in the third quarter after that touchdown, 14-3. With the score 14-6, Henry a 14-yard run. And then this is Henry who runs tough. You know, he played hurt a lot of the year. The line has not had a great year, but he can be like this.
Yeah, when he is healthy, you see him run bigger than he is. He's able to overpower people once he gets through the line, and that will set up play-action pass for them.
And that set up a field goal. Meanwhile, Pennington is picked off by Terrence McGee. Me and Terrence McGee. And Herm not happy on this one as the Bills. Well, now the Bills, you know, hey, the Bills have won a couple in a row here, circling one wagon at a time. And despite only 9 of 15 passing from Drew Bledsoe, a career high for Travis Henry, 169 yards. Buffalo is the team that's 6-7. They also had 5 sacks today, their defense.
Yeah, defense playing well. And we said this time of year, said it this morning on Countdown, now we want that running game to really take hold of our offensive game plan.
And a lot of things. Buffalo Bills to Tennessee for the first time since the Music City Miracle, 1999. It's fitting that Wade Phillips is a head coach again these days. Steve McNair tested the leg before the game, but it's Billy Volek from Fresno State.
Yeah.
Going to make the start, Tom, his first start. But very early in the third quarter, Jeff Posey the strip, and the big fella, Pat Williams. Williams, rumbling, bumbling, stumbling. Touchdown, Buffalo. Their defense is very good. 17-6 Bills. But here comes Keith Bullock with the strip of Drew Bledsoe. Bullock also recovers. So, now, Tennessee in business, down by 11. Bullock. The big tight end, Aaron Kinney. Touchdown, McNair. Sidelines, yes, sir. Two-point Titans. Conversion, yes. 17-14. Bullock. To Derek Mason. After a review, it was ruled a catch, and it was a good review. He was in. Then Bullock to Justin McCarron's, and just like that, Tennessee has come back, leading at 21-20. Screen to Eddie George. Looks like the old Eddie George until the end of the play. To the four, it's a bumbo! But Mason is right there for Tennessee. So second and goal, Bullock to sneak. Touchdown. Billy Bullock pumped. Heaves it in the crowd. Titans lead 28-20. The game's about over. Bledsoe is really struggling, but on fourth and two, minute and a half to go, to Bobby Shaw, the Shankshaw redemption. 44 yards, Buffalo in position. Bledsoe, look at the touch here. Nice to Mark Campbell. It's a two-point game, 28-26, and here comes the two-point conversion. That's the flutiest. Bledsoe rolling out right. Incomplete. Well, they would review it. Shaw says, look, I'm showing the ref that I caught the ball, and when I put it up in the air, I lost it.
Hold on to it.
He explains it. The ref doesn't buy it. And Bullock and the Titans escape what could have been not a disaster, but would have been three straight losses for the Tennessee Titans. Instead, they win it, and so they go to 10-4, still in the driver's seat for a wild card berth, or still alive because Indianapolis clinched a playoff berth.
The Dolphins go to Buffalo in December. So many times the burial ground for this team, whether it's in the playoffs. And Van Biller, he's called Buffalo Bill games for a long, long time. As in 37 years, calling his last home game. So very early on, Tim Bowens hits Drew Bledsoe. Van didn't like calling this as Zach Thomas recovers the fumble, 6 Dolphin sacks. 2.5 by Jason Taylor. Here's Bledsoe sack, Reuben Brown, a Pro Bowl, guards it, what?
Well, that reaction is because oftentimes they feel that Drew's holding on to the ball a little long.
Well, this time he got rid of it. Into the hands of T-Buck, feast or famine, and Terrell Buckley takes a 13-3 game and makes it a Dolphin romp. 20 to get in there, T-Buck. Get in there. So Van Miller's final home broadcast, not the way he wanted. And you know what? Here's another team that now the chips were down. But look, Tom, Miami played New England and Philly 2 in a row. They hadn't lost in over 2 months. So now they go up to Buffalo. They get the 6 sacks, 2.5 from Jason Taylor, 12 tackles by Zach Thomas. The Bills had 11 yards in the first half.
Yeah, and you look at that offensive game plan, 8 completions by Jay Fiedler, but the 29 carries by Ricky Williams. You can see how Dave Wannstedt is going to try to get to the playoffs. You know what?
The Patriots' final regular season game had fans thinking back to the first one. Judging by the Patriots' most dominating performance of the year, that 31-0 week 1 loss in Buffalo was likely on the players' minds as well.
Brady's back to throw. Steps, fires over the middle, caught by David Gibbons, into the end! Looking left, fires left, caught there by Bethel Johnson, scoots it down, and in! Touchdown!
By halftime, the Patriots' lead was 28-0.
Tom Brady has thrown 4 first half touchdown passes.
Ahead 31-0 in the second half, the Patriots' defense did their best to make the ironic reversal in score hold. Bills drove into Patriots territory 4 times, but the proud Patriots defense forced turnover after turnover and refused to surrender a single point.